Hello, and welcome to another Ask Excite. I'm Tim Bushnell with Expert Cytometry, and today's question comes from Eric. And Eric asks, what is this peak 2 method you talk about in your blog post? Now, that's a great question, Eric. The peak 2 method is a way for us to measure the sensitivity of a photomultiplier tube. What we do, and this was published in a paper by Maecker and Trotter in Cytometry A in 2006, is we take these dim particles, the second peak of this, in this case, the Spherotech 8-peak bead set, and we run those beads over a voltage series, starting at, say, 200 volts up to 900 volts. We run these at 50-volt increments. We then measure the spread of the data, the CV of the bead, and plot it against the voltage. What happens is we see that at low voltage, the CVs are very high, and as we increase the voltages, the CVs get lower and lower. And they come to a point where there's an inflection point, and then they stay at that level. What we found, and what they reported in this Maecker and Trotter paper, is at that level, that inflection point, is the best, most sensitive point for that PMT. Now, we can further improve this by doing a voltage optimization of our cells and antibody of interest, but in general, we find that inflection point that is a good range for you to start and run your experiments at. And it's a good way to standardize your experiment rather than always coming into the instrument and trying to adjust the voltages. So that's what the peak 2 method is, and that's why we use it. So thanks for your question, and thanks for listening to another Ask Excite. Until next time, be sure to keep up with flow cytometry best practices right here with your friends in flow, Tim and Team Excite.